According to the annual crime report of 2022, Uganda registered 20,394 cases of road accidents in 2022 compared to 17,443 registered the previous year. 4,500 people died in road crashes in 2022. Out of every 100 crashes, 22 people died, while 61% of all accidents were as a result of reckless driving. To mitigate the carnage, the Parliamentary Forum on Road Safety, in partnership with the World Health Organization and World Bank, is hosting the International Convention on Road Safety in Munyonyo starting tomorrow. This to deliberate on measures to reduce road carnage in sub-Saharan Africa.
It is so unfortunate that we lose close to 4,000 people every year. We have seen that in terms of GDP, when the economists compute the figures, we lose close to 4.5 trillion every year. And such losses are unbearable, and an economy can never grow when your human capital is being lost at such a terrific rate.
The forum has welcomed the proposed amendments in the Road Safety Act, which seeks to provide a fine of 2 million shillings for overspeeding. MPs have hope in the intelligent transport monitoring system, where the government is going to install digital trackers on motor vehicles as a breakthrough that will restore sanity on roads.
I think the intention is not to charge money, is to make it very punitive for one to overspeed, because it has been identified that one of the most what is increasing the road carnage is overspeeding.
They are going to get these number plates, new number plates. We are going to have the ones that can correspond with the camera. So that is going to happen. At the same time, we are going to see, you know, we revised the law to make sure that if you kill people, you have to be held responsible for manslaughter. So you know, this is carelessness which we have seen. You know, it has really gone beyond.
The ITMS will also work is an improved way of integrating all those forms of fines. But to answer it together with the other one is that all those fines that police has been charging and whatever, still it's the police which is the implementer. But it has become a bit tricky for police to be everywhere.
The forum has, however, urged the government and KCCA to find urgent solutions for the ever-increasing potholes on roads.
Once there are potholes on the road, that road becomes unsafe. But for case of Kampala, we have nothing to do. We don't have any other means of transport. It's all road transport. That's why we're still going through those potholes.
MPs on the Road Safety Forum also believe that 236.3 million shillings spent daily to treat critical accident victims and the 344.2 million shillings spent daily on moderately ill accident victims, as highlighted by the Health Committee report, is a tall order on both the government and the taxpayer.
One of the areas where Uganda is losing a lot is to do with road safety. Our roads are not secure. There is a lot of road carnages, but we do want to see no death, or we reduce on the people dying on our roads.
We have to get a holistic solution to these problems. We have been analyzing the causes of the road accidents. We have narrow roads, because now you have narrow roads and the overtaking becomes a problem. These roads are not separated. So that is one of the major causes of the crashes.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.